Hello, I'm Yevgeni Yeliseyev, a teacher of Russian language from russianwithrussian.com.
In our previous lesson, we talked about the verb to have in Russian language, and I said that in some situations the word есть, which is a part of the expression у меня есть, I have, may be omitted. And that is what we will discuss today. The word есть is often omitted when the sentence describes a state and not a possession of something. У меня насморк. I have a runny nose. У меня кашель. I have a cough. У меня мигрень. I have a migraine. Here we omit the word есть because these sentences mean that I am in a state of sickness. But if we want to emphasize the presence of symptoms, есть may be added.
Думаю, я простудился. Почему ты так думаешь? У тебя есть насморк, кашель или какие-нибудь другие симптомы?
I think I caught a cold. Why do you think so? Do you have a runny nose, cough, or any other symptoms? Here we highlight the presence of symptoms. I have symptoms, so I have a disease. Other examples.
У меня проблемы.
I have problems. I have troubles. Here the verb to have describes my worrying state because of my problems.
But я не могу пойти с тобой в кино, так как у меня есть проблемы, требующие немедленного решения.
I can't go to the cinema with you because I have problems that need an immediate solution. I have problems to be solved immediately. That's why I don't have time.
У меня гости.
I'm having guests. I'm not alone. There are guests around me. But I'm not the owner of these guests.
But вчера ты приглашал гостей. Кто-нибудь пришел? Да, у меня есть гости.
Yesterday you invited guests. Has anyone come? Yes, I have guests. I do have guests. Here I emphasize the presence of guests in my house.
У меня двое детей.
I have two children. I am a father of two children. That is my state, my status.
But у меня нет денег, но у меня есть двое детей, и они мое самое большое богатство.
I have no money, but I have two children, and they are my greatest wealth. Here I want to say that I don't have money, but I do have children.
Or, в отличие от тебя, у меня есть дети.
Unlike you, I do have children. I do have children, but you don't have them. Есть may be omitted when we talk about the things that are always present or we know in advance about their existence.
У Андрея зеленые глаза.
Andrei has green eyes. Есть has been omitted because the fact that a person has eyes is obvious. Every person has eyes. The sentence just informs us about the color of Andrei's eyes. His eyes are green.
У нее красивая улыбка.
She has a beautiful smile. Есть has been omitted because almost everyone can smile. So the fact that she has a smile is obvious, and the sentence just informs us that her smile is beautiful.
But у Ольги нет высшего образования, но у нее есть красивая улыбка, помогающая ей добиться всего, чего она хочет.
Olga doesn't have higher education, but she has a beautiful smile, which helps her to achieve everything she wants. Here we emphasize that Olga doesn't have higher education, but she does have a beautiful smile. Есть is often omitted before quantitative pronouns, that is, before such words as много, many, much, мало, few, little, немного, a little, немало, not a little, несколько, a few, столько, so many, so much. У меня много дел. I have many things to do. I have a lot to do. Есть has been omitted before the word много, many. But у меня есть много дел, которые нужно сделать сегодня. Поэтому я не смогу пойти на вечеринку. I have many things that need to be done today, so I can't go to the party. I do have things to do, that's why I don't have time. У меня к тебе несколько вопросов. I have a few questions for you. Before the word несколько, a few, the word есть is omitted. But я сделаю то, о чем ты просишь, но у меня есть к тебе несколько вопросов. I'll do what you are asking, but I have a few questions for you. I have questions, that's why I don't have ability to do what you are asking me to do. When you answer all these questions, I will have ability to get to work. We also prefer to omit the word есть in the questions, beginning with the word сколько, how many, how much. For example, the question how many cars do you have may be asked in the following ways. Сколько у тебя машин? Or сколько машин у тебя есть? Or сколько у тебя есть машин? The first one is the most common. The third one is less used. As you can see, everything depends on the context. But if you have doubt if you should use the word есть in the above mentioned situations or not, it's better to omit it when the verb to have describes a state, when we are talking about the things that are always present or we know in advance about their existence. When before a noun, there are such words as много, мало, немного, немало, несколько, столько. When the question begins with the word сколько, how many, how much. Just a little practice and the word есть will give you no troubles. Well, that's all for now. In the next lesson, we will talk about how to express a possession of something in the past and future tenses. So, stay with us. If you enjoyed the video, please subscribe to my channel, leave comments, and visit my website to get more information about Russian language and private Russian Skype lessons. Thanks for watching, have a nice day, see you at the next video.